Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 19 on EA Sports. We are just moments away from what should be an excellent matchup between the Los Angeles Chargers and the Pittsburgh Steelers. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner is standing by to call the action. Here are Brandon Godfrey and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. A few moments ago, the Steeler offensive starters, including all-pro wideout Antonio Brown, were introduced. And they've got this crowd in a frenzy as they get set to square off with the Los Angeles Chargers. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we look at this Steeler ball club entering play. The streak continues, doesn't it? They come in here a perfect 11-0. Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Chargers, they've certainly found their groove of late, winners of 5 in a row.
And I think the sky's the limit for this team. They're playing the best football that they've played in a long time.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. Gets this one to Le'Veon Bell. And all the way down to the 35. It's a big play there for the Steelers. And even 40 yards.
Brandon, sometimes we give a lot of these running backs credit for being good receivers, and all they catch are swings and screens. Le'Veon Bell's a full member of the passing game for the Pittsburgh Steelers, whether he's split out of the backfield or not.
Well, no doubt he can catch it, coming off a career-high 85 receptions in 2017.
Here we go.
They'll look to throw now on first down. On the left side, it's McDonald. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
They'll look to throw here on first down. This is Bell on the dump off. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you want.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Melvin Ingram in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. First and second down were a disaster. Both went backwards. Now it's third and 18. They need something big.
Here we go. White, 90.
Looking to throw. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. Pretty good job escaping the pressure. Gets him 15 yards on the scramble, but now it's fourth down.
I thought he did a pretty good job there to get back what he could, but let's face it, that sack on second down, talk about throwing a wrench into the works. It certainly did.
Yeah, he did everything he could there, trying to pick up some positive yardage, and he did, but not enough. The Steelers offense, now they head back onto the field. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point,
the kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
They're looking at a second and short yardage to start things out.
Hey, 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 hey. Let's go. Grand 38.
He'll look to throw. Throw left side, complete to Smith-Schuster. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. His first catch, good for 9 in the first down.
Let's go!
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Vance McDonald, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers are able to strike for six.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think
play fake here on first down. Runs through the contact. Chargers able to get the pressure and bring him down. Denzel Perryman in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Like the footwork back there. I thought he did a pretty good job of evading that first wave of players. Tried to buy a little extra time out of the pocket, but in the end, oh, that was a tough one.
Yeah, winds up getting buried for the loss. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And out across midfield down to the 45. And a nice gain of 21 yards. And that catch puts him past the great Jerry Rice. For the most receiving yards in a single season, he's now up over 1,848.
At one point, we called Jerry Rice Flash. How about the dash we saw here today? The dash toward...
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Melvin Ingram, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year.
Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. A heck of an effort there on the scramble leaves him with just third and a yard.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Now back to throw. Open man, Smith-Schuster, it's complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. And they convert on third with a gain of 22.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. A minute 58 to go in this first half of play. Back to Heinz Field after this. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
The quick slant caught. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's first and goal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective. They're able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Flush to his right. And he's in for 6 and a Steeler touchdown. It's their quarterback with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the 2nd quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
Okay, we got four down, let's go.
After the incomplete pass, here now is 2nd and 10.
Come on!
Back to throw. And fights through one man. He's going deep for, and got his man, complete. The 40. Pass the 20. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And they extend their lead, a little added cushion into the lockers. What a way to finish.
Tremendous way. That's momentum that they carry in with them. Can they convert it and bring it back out to start the 3rd quarter?
They go play action here on first down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But it looked like the Steelers were able to recover, and they will indeed hold on to the ball.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess.
The Steelers on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and forever.
Let's go! Grand 38! Grand 38!
He'll drop to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up 4th down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL.
corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. And the Steelers set to take the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball.
And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Melvin Ingram in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year.
Like how they've started the third quarter here. They force a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room.
Four down.
They'll look to throw. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Joey Bosa in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Well, Brandon, there's no question who they're going to look to on third and long, but you can bet this defense knows that as well, so they've got him blanketed downfield. And this ball winds up being intercepted.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Well, that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point. They continue to give you speed.
That's caught inside the 20. And he's taken down all the way inside the L.A. 10. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 57 yards. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gardens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. And that touchdown, Steelers! And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the numbers. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their...
come out throwing here to start the drive. And an alley to run. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. At this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Under four to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. They'll set up a throw. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. They'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of three, but now it's third down.
Looked to me like they adopted what my kindergarten teacher always said. If at first you don't succeed, try again. And finally, able to hold him in check. He'd been carving him up running the ball.
That's the first time I think I've seen where the coverage was good downfield and they accounted for him and stopped him for a short pickup.
Yeah, I don't think there's a big adjustment, but much more emphasis on making sure they knew where he was when he decided to take off and go.
It's a first down, and he's also over 190 receiving yards now. What a game. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They'll set up to throw on the crossing route, complete. That's James, and he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. He'll look to throw. Dancing to his left, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Ben Heaney in there with pressure yet again, and that's the seventh time they've dropped him here this afternoon. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead.
Come on, let's go! 190! 190! Cut!
They're going to look to throw. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. It's first and goal and a late touchdown at this stage. Could officially salt this one away.
Four down.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. This will be caught at about the five. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Back to throw here. Flushed out right. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. Drop to throw, escaping the pressure right. And this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out.
Illegal touching, offense.
game. Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it. Line of scrimmage, again, the 25, second and 10. He's back to throw. And he finds a man in the crossing route. And he's going to be ripped down by the face mask at the end of this, and that's going to add 15 more onto the end of this thing.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Tack on 15 more for the face mask, and that becomes a huge play.
Big pass gets caught on you. You're doing everything possible to get him on the ground, and sometimes you end up grabbing the face mask.
He'll look to throw. And this is caught at the 8. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Eluding the pressure right. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass.
So a very interesting final chapter to this proverbial book here in this one, because they were in field goal range, could have won it with a field goal, elect to go for the touchdown. I still don't know what they were doing.
As great as this game was and as dramatic an ending as we had, the post-game press conference is going to be key, because they're going to be asking Coach, why not a field goal attempt there? You got an opportunity to win it right there with your guy, and instead you run another play.
Yeah, we might need to stop by that press conference on our way out the back door here.
Yeah, just slow down the plane for us, all right? We gotta get an answer before we go.
So for the Steelers, the streak continues as they push their mark to a perfect 12-0 now on the year. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the Oakland Raiders. Meanwhile, for our visitors, it was a win they needed to turn the season around, but instead, they fall to 5-7. And they'll try to turn things around next week as they have a matchup in Cincinnati against the Bengals.
Cool.